Hi there! Welcome to my channel. In today's video, we are going to review another paper for direct speech-to-speech translation. If you have been following the recent content on this channel, you know that we have been reviewing papers in the direct speech-to-speech translation area. Namely, what we have studied so far are two things. We have studied two models. One is called Translatortron 1. And the another one was called Translatortron 2. So these are the two models that we have studied so far. And then we also studied another model, which is not a direct speech-to-speech translation model, but it's an important model. It's called Hubert. So these are the three papers that we have recently studied. So Translatortron 1 and Translatortron 2 are both direct speech-to-speech translation model. And these models, what they do is, they take the speech in one language and translate into speech in another language. And the important thing is that the input that goes into the model is the spectrogram of the source language. And what it gives out is also the spectrogram of the target language. So that's the key here. Then we studied another model called Hubert, which is not a speech-to-speech translation model. However, it is a model that tells us how we can represent speech, which is a continuous input, by discrete units. So these are the three things that we have studied so far. In today's video, the paper that we are going to study is for direct speech-to-speech translation. However, it is different than Translatortron 1 and 2 in that it does not output the spectrogram. What it outputs is the discrete unit for the target language. So that's the most important thing to distinguish between how the Translatortron models translate and how this new model that we're going to study translates. So if you have not read the Hubert paper, I would highly suggest that you read Hubert paper, because that is the key in this paper, at least one of the key things in this paper. So with that brief introduction or background, let's get into the details of this particular paper. The title of this paper is Direct Speech-to-Speech Translation with Discrete Units. So this discrete units is what makes it different than Translatortron 1 or Translatortron 2. This is a paper that was published in March of 2022 by Meta AI and Johns Hopkins. So at a very high level, let's once again, I'm going to repeat here myself, so just bear with me. So what's new in this approach of direct speech-to-speech translation is that it is using discrete unit, whereas the Translatortron models, they use the spectrograms for predicting for the target language. Also, another thing that makes this method different than Translatortron is that when we train a model, we don't need any text for training the model. We just need the speech in one language and speech in another language to train this model. So that's another difference. for this approach. So what it does is, again, this discrete unit is really important to understand what that is. So I'll briefly explain what that is, but again, please read the Hubert paper for good understanding. So what is discrete unit? So now speech is a continuous input. What we want to be able to do is we want to be able to represent this continuous input by discrete units. So that's what the Hubert paper, Hubert model does. So in this paper or in this approach for direct speech-to-speech translation, what the authors do is they do two main things. First of all, they use the Hubert model to convert the speech, continuous speech, into discrete units. So they apply this Hubert model on the target speech and they convert all the speech into discrete units. So that's first thing. And then the second thing, of course, is that we want to translate from the source language to the target language. So the source language, let's say, is Spanish, and let's say the target language is English. So we will feed some kind of input. In this case, they're using the MEL spectrogram. So we feed the spectrogram of the source language, which is Spanish, and then we pass it through the model, and we train the model to predict the discrete units of the target language. So that's really the key. Let's go into the details to understand further what that means. So here we just stated, so it's again, we first apply the self-supervised discrete speech encoder, which is Hubert, on the target speech to generate those discrete units. And then we train a model to predict those discrete units for the target language. Another thing that they say here is that if you have the text available for a language, what I mean to say is that if that language that we are trying to translate to has a written form, then this model is also able to predict the text. So in that case, it becomes a joint speech and text prediction model. So we do not need any text for training. This is just saying that we will be able to predict the text in the target language if that language has a written form. Here they show through their experiments, and they have so many experiments that they did for this paper, which is great. And they show through the experiments that this model performs a little bit better than the translator drone models that predict the spectrogram features. All right, so we can skip this. Let's go into the model directly and understand what the model looks like. Pictorially, the model looks like this. It's straightforward. It's a transformer-based model. If you're familiar with transformer, I hope you are, because that is another very important paper in NLP and in machine learning, in deep learning in general. So the transformer model consists of an encoder, and then we have a multi-head attention, and we have a decoder. So this is our standard transformer model. The difference is that, or I guess the highlight is that, what goes into this model is the log MEL spectrograms of the source language of the speech of the source language. And that goes into the encoder, multi-headed attention, and then we have the decoder. So this decoder is trained to predict the discrete units of the target language. So it takes in the spectrogram and predicts the discrete units. Another thing that is important is that during the training, we do need, or at least for this particular approach, the authors said that we do need to train this auxiliary tasks, which is for predicting things like phonemes or letters or characters. So this is an auxiliary task that we need to add during the training, because this gives better performance. And if you remember the translator-tron models, they also used the same approach. So these authors also use the same approach because they feel that training with these auxiliary tasks gives us better performance. And then one last thing here is this branch here. So this branch is only for the languages that have written form. So it's just saying that if the language has a written form, then we are able to predict not just the speech, but also the text. So this is really what the model looks like. So it's a transformer-based model. Finally, one thing that we haven't talked about yet is the vocoder. What does vocoder do? So this vocoder, because eventually what we want to get out is, like, if we think of practical applications, we want to be able to hear the speech in a target language. That's where this vocoder comes into play. This vocoder takes these discrete units and converts that into a waveform which we can listen. So that's the overall model. So this training for this transformer model happens independently from the training of this vocoder. So they both are trained separately. But in a nutshell, this is the overall model. And we just talked about this, so I will let you read the paper, but what I just said is the summary of this description here. I guess one main thing that I forgot to mention when I was going through the model is that it's not shown in the description here, in the picture here. However, the authors do use 1D convolutional layer before they pass the input to the transformer encoder. So as you can see, so the ML spectrogram first goes through the 1D convolutional layer, and that whatever comes out of the CNN, that then goes to the transformer encoder here. Okay, and then we talked about the vocoder, and then here, now they're going to the experiments and the system setup. So here, I'm gonna let you read through all these experiments that they have done. They have done lots of experiments, and I'm gonna stop here for this paper. So this is just one of the first papers in this domain. When I say in this domain, what I mean by that is these same authors or similar set of authors, they have two other papers after they published this paper, which will follow a similar approach. So this is just one of the three papers that we are going to end the video with today. And I'm going to have two other papers which are follow-on to this work and improvement over this work. So with that, we will end the video here, and I hope this was helpful. Please do read the paper, because I did not cover everything that was in the experiments, and the experiments are really important. Thank you, and I wish you best in your research, and I'll see you in my next video. Thank you.